Could have used a little more cowbell.
Hey there, Apple Valley. Welcome to this year's final edition of EaglEye Live.
I'm Brian Johnson.
And I'm Jill Catterlick. Today's show is all about spring travels.
We'll travel back in time with some teachers and catch Professor Kyle before he takes off.
We'll also take a trip to the athletic fields to wrap up our spring sports. But first, let's go down under with our graduation party hoppers, Katie and Jana.
Good day, mates. Here we are at one of the most wild and unique events of the season.
Crikey, that's right. It's a graduation party. And it's a beauty. Come on, let's take a closer look.
Parties stand out from the crowd by incorporating themes, which can be seen in the excursion we took to the luau theme party at Chevela Commissar.
Even if you don't have a theme, food is essential in taming ferocious party guests. Corianna Brownski tried something new in whipping up a breakfast souffle. Holly Christian had another mouth-watering idea.
So I kind of was like, hey, everyone likes desserts, everyone likes chocolate. I love chocolate, so let's make it all chocolate.
Speaking of chocolate, everyone having a party should take the following into account.
Chocolate fountains!
But of course.
Be careful though, it can make quite the mess. That's not the only mess you have to clean up though.
My mom made me sweep and clean every corner of my bedroom, even though no one's even going to get close to it, okay? But they still had to go under my bed and have a little dust there, you know?
All the hard work pays off when you see all your best mates supporting your greatest accomplishment.
I'm really excited for the grad party to see everyone who, like, cares about us, and it's a big relief to have all the planning done.
After investigating these parties, hopefully you can grow up on your own. I'm the Bobby.
Reporting for EaglEye with Katie Schutt
and Jana Hossman.
Crikey!
Those two hit a lot of parties. Thanks, Grad Hoppers.
For our Eagle athletes, there's a lot to celebrate, too. Let's go to Jamaica with the Eagle Sport Report.
I'm going to state in boys tennis. It should be a blast, and I'm looking forward to winning a couple matches.
Eagle pride is flying high as many athletes are representing Apple Valley at the state level this spring. Adaptive Softball was jumping for joy after winning the state championship last weekend. Congratulations to the team. Boys Tennis is proud to be sending sophomore Joey McGibbon to the state tournament today. Meanwhile in golf, senior Tyler Eckenberg qualified for the state tournament and has been competing this week. The East Valley rugby team is heading to the state semifinal tournament and will be competing Saturday. And in track, Apple Valley has a slew of people heading off to the state meet tomorrow. Congratulations and good luck to everyone who will be representing us at the state level this spring. That's all for Eagle Sports. Back to you.
Thanks, Jamaica. Congratulations to all of our Eagle athletes this year.
Since this is our last show of the year, we figured we better give the much requested Professor Kyle the last word.
What I like to use it for is not only for poetry, but also for life lessons.
Hello. Today's lesson is more of an English lesson than a life lesson, but it's quite interchangeable. Today's word is synecdoche.
Synecdoche is a surgery that you have. Synecdoche is an ingredient in Pop-Tarts.
It's an underwater swimming creature.
Synecdoche means for a part to represent a whole, such as all hands on deck. Not meaning just hands on deck, but people. With the end of the year approaching and all of us moving on, I'm ready to close the book on Word of the Day.
In the spirit of synecdoche, let's give Professor Kyle a hand for his work in the library.
Prom may still be 2 days away for us, but for these teachers, well, let's just say it's been a while. Let's travel back in time to look at some of our faculty members who have already had the time of their life.
always good to reminisce on those high school memories.
Yeah, but I think Miss Voss and Miss Heinemann would like to forget those fashions.
That's all for today. It's been a good year, Apple Valley.
Have a great summer.
Never looking back again. You found somebody who does it better.